Have you ever wondered how an artist creates a painting? I'm sure it all starts with an idea that's inspired by something they're interested in, like a person they know, place they love, or even an abstract idea. But whatever it is, they all use brushes, paint, and a canvas to make their idea a reality. Well, game developers are the same way. We all have an idea for a game, and we use assets, code, and Unity to make it happen. Except game developers have something that artists don't have. And I'm going to share that with you in just a moment. But first, my name is Charles, and this is Infallible Code, a channel designed to make you a better game developer. If you'd like to learn more about Unity, programming, and game development, then be sure to subscribe to this channel. And don't forget to hit that bell icon. So, painters, they all use a variety of tools to complete their works of art, but they don't really have anything to increase their efficiency, meaning that apart from practicing technique, there's no way for an artist to paint faster. Game developers do not have this problem, and that's exactly what we'll be covering in this video and this new monthly series where I'll be sharing with you some of my favorite productivity assets that were designed to help you finish your game faster. This month, we'll be taking a look at a simple and lightweight asset that'll speed up your workflow and save you thousands of mouse clicks. Trust me, your mouse will thank me. Now, over the course of this series, you'll probably see me cover more than one hierarchy asset, but Enhanced Hierarchy 2.0 is one of the simplest and lightest of the lot, which is a huge plus for small projects that don't really have complicated hierarchies. I mean, just look how quick and painless it is to install. Ready? Boom, no setup required. Which is great, but what can it do? Well, at first glance, you'll notice that our hierarchy is now striped, already a vast improvement. But there's more than meets the eye. Now, when we hover over a game object, we get a short summary that reveals its name, tag, layer, and components. And if we're just curious about scripts, all we have to do is move our mouse over the script icon, and we'll get a list containing just the mono behaviors. Moving to the right, we can see that some game objects have labels. These signify the tag and or layer that they're associated with, and we can click them to quickly modify their values. Next is this set of icons all the way to the right. In a moment, I'll show you how to customize these, but out of the box, each game object has four icons that act as shortcuts for common actions. The A icon can be used to both create new prefabs and apply changes to existing prefabs. The pencil icon makes the game object static. The lock icon locks the game object so it can't be updated or moved, definitely one of my favorites. And the eye icon enables and disables the game object. Together, these four buttons save you from a lot of extra clicking. And like I said, we can actually customize these from the preferences. Let's do that now. We can see that there are a ton of visual options. For instance, we can change the margins and indents, which is pretty nice. We can set up some highlighting based on the game object's current layer. As we can see here and in the hierarchy, the UI layer is blue by default, but we can easily change it. And then down at the bottom is the section I mentioned for customizing icons, which I highly recommend exploring. One in particular is the logs, warnings, and errors icon that's currently displayed next to the object name and is incredibly valuable. To see it in action, all we need to do is run the scene where I've added some code that throws an exception. Now, the game object that was responsible for throwing that exception has an error icon next to its name, which we can mouse over to see a snippet of the error. Of course, we do have to stop the scene. And that about covers it.
So, as you can see, Enhanced Hierarchy 2.0 has a ton of great features that'll speed up your workflow. At just $10, it is an affordable productivity asset that is still under active development and has great support. Speaking of support, if you'd like to support this channel, then please consider using the affiliate link in the description of this video. And for a limited amount of time, if this is your first purchase, then you can use my coupon, also in the description of this video, to save 10%. You don't want to miss it. So if you have any comments, please leave those below. And if not, I'll see you next month for another great productivity asset. Catch you later.